वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषये भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादम् शङ्करं लोकशङ्करम् सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणम् तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम् ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुदिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम् अम्बत्वामनुसन्दधाभि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणी मूकं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुं लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपात्तमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवम् नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। अथ तृतीयोऽध्यायः। श्रीभगवानुवाच श्लोकान्वर्ष नियतं कुरु कर्म त्वं
नियतं कुरु
कर्म ज्यायो ह्य कर्मणः शरीरयात्रापि च ते
शरीरयात्रापि च ते
न प्रसिद्ध्येद कर्मणः यज्ञार्थात् कर्मणो न्यत्र कोयम् कर्म बंधनः
लोकोयम् कर्म बंधनः
तदर्थं कर्म कौन्तेय मुक्तसङ्गः समाचर सह यज्ञाः प्रजा सृष्ट्वा उरोवाच प्रजापतिः अनेन प्रसविष्यत्वम् येषवोऽस्त्विष्टका मधुक् Starting from the fourth shloka onwards, Bhagavan Krishna talks about karma yoga, the importance of karma and karma yoga. Importance of karma is nobody can remain without any action. Sharira yatra pichate na prasiddhye na karmanaha. Therefore, niyatam karma kuru. Niyatam karma kuru, that is karma yoga. Niyatam vigitam, the karma which is vigitam. Shastrehi vigitam karma kuru. That which is ordained by the shastram, you do it. And that which is vigittam by shastram, ordained by shastram. How we have to do it? You have to do it as a sadhanam, as a yoga. Sadhanam for what? Sadhanam for gaining the end. What is the end? The end is abhyudaya nishrayasa phalam. Abhyudaya nishrayasa phalam. For both material and spiritual prosperity. Karma yoga will give you the material prosperity, and through that you gain chitta shuddhi, therefore spiritual prosperity also. Antakarna shuddhi also through karma yoga. To take up a karma as a yoga, you have to accept Shastram and Ishvara. Without Shastram, without accepting Shastram, without accepting Ishvara, there is no Karma Yoga. Without Ishvara, there is no Karma Yoga. Without Shastram, Ishvara itself, no, you will not believe. Because Shastram only talks about Ishvara, Bhagavan. So, without Ishvara, without bringing Ishvara into your daily action, there is no karma yoga possible. Therefore, karma yoga, when we say Ishvara is there, when Ishvara is there, so Ishvara is presented, it is pratipaditam by Shastram. Therefore, Bhagavan is there. When you bring in Bhagavan in your action, then that action becomes a yoga, a sadhana. For what? For gaining abhyudaya nishrayasa. For gaining Bhagavan itself, it becomes a sadhana. By gaining chitta shuddhi, chitta shuddhya, jnani, chitta shuddhi is jnana yogyata praptihi. So therefore, karma yogena jnana yogyata praptihi. Jnana yogena moksha praptihi, ishvara praptihi. Therefore, karma yoga becomes a sadhanam yoga. Therefore, it is called karma yoga. Yoga means sadhana. Yujyate. Yujyate anena iti yogaha. That which by you are connected. Yujyate sadhyate. By which you gain. Therefore, it becomes a sadhanam. So, that is karma yoga. So, that karma yoga, when we say this karma, the action which is propelled by a kama, a desire, then it is called sakama karma. Karma can be of two types. One is sakama karma, that is kamena saha vartate sakama. Second one is nishkama, that it is nishkama karma is not based on your raga dvesha. Nishkama karma, it is not based on your raga dvesha, not propelled by raga dvesha, your likes and dislikes. You do a karma, that type of karma, nishkama karma, propelled by raga dvesha, propelled by desires, desire prompted action, they are called sakama karma. And there are nishiddha karma also. Nishiddha karma, the prohibited actions, doing which you, prohibited by shastra, doing which you gain papam. The papam will present unfavorable situation and therefore suffer. That is nishiddha karma. And another karma, prayasita karma, the karma by which the papam are neutralized, or not neutralized, their papam are expired, it is atoned. So to be a karma yogi, a person must not do nishiddha karma. You should give up nishiddha karma, and when nishiddha karma is given up, there is no question of prashchitta karma. Only when you do prohibited action, then only you have to do prashchitta. So that also not there. So therefore, either nishkama or sakama. Now, among them, which one a karma yogi should have more? You can ask only more. A karma yogi can have kama, can have desires, as long as the desires are in keeping with dharma. So there is no problem if the karma is prompted by desire, the kama, and the kama is in keeping with dharma. But as a karma yogi, the person must have more of nishkama, that is not driven by raga dvesha. Therefore only shastram for a karma yogi presents in the lifestyle, in everyday life, the five types of karma to be followed. Five types of karma to be followed by a karma yogi. They are called panchamaha yajna. That is what niyatam kuru karmatvam. Niyatam kuru, the karma which is vigitam by the shastram, is panchamaha yajna. The panchamaha yajna to be followed by the people belonging to any varna, any ashrama. In addition to the karma which are to be followed in keeping with Varna Ashrama. In addition to that, this Panchamaha Yajna, this karma, Panchamaha Yajna, they are Nishkama karma to be followed. They are Deva Yajna, Pitra Yajna, we discussed about all these Yajna, Rishi Yajna, then Bhuta Yajna, and Manushya Yajna, iti, five types of this Yajna. It is called Yajna. Yajna, the word is derived from the dhatu yaj. Yaj means to worship. So yajna is a worship, is a yaga. So the karma becomes a worship. The karma becomes a worship of the Lord. So you don't worship the Lord out of fear. You worship the Lord out of gratitude, out of bhakti, out of devotion. So when a karma yogi necessarily has to be a bhakta, so therefore bhakti as a separate yoga, really speaking, not there. Who is a real bhakta? Who is the ultimate bhakta? That Bhagavan Krishna says ultimate bhakta is a jnani. Jnani is the ultimate bhakta because he is not different from me, Bhagavan Krishna says later, we will see. But a bhakta, a karma yogi only can be a bhakta. because he does karma not out of fear of the punishment, not out of the fear of violation of prohibiting what is to be done or doing what is doing the prohibited action, doing what is not to be done, or avoiding what is to be done. He doesn't do out of he doesn't do any karma out of fear, nor he doesn't violate the order, violate any dharma, because he loves the Lord. He has love and he has gratitude, he has appreciation of the order. Therefore, he does karma in keeping with his varna and ashrama and dharma. Therefore, the karma yogi can only be a real bhakta. He's not a God-fearing person. In fact, he's a God-loving person. In the beginning, one has to be driven by the fear, because the pakvata, the maturity is not there. Therefore, we have to tell in the beginning, as a child is instructed, if you don't do this, you will get punished. Similarly, if you don't do this, then Bhagavan will punish you. In the beginning, it's a threat. It is like a threat. You threat a child. Similarly, the people are also given such a threat, but it is not really a threat. It is only for the sake of making them follow dharma, follow karma. Even in Shastram also, it is such words are there. This the word called bhaya. The word bhaya, vishas matvata pavate in Taittiriya Upanishad. It is said, vishode ti suryaha, vishas matagnischendrascha, mrityurdhavati panchama. Iti. That is visha, vishas mat vataha pavate. Vataha, the wind blows out of visha, the fear. Fear of what? Fear of the Lord. Fear of Lord, because of that sun rises, Agni, Indra, and everything, Mrityu, the death, everything functions because of the fear. But really, it is not a fear, it is the order. It is the order of Ishvara. Understanding the order, everything functions. So, in the beginning, it is a fear that is only for a karmi, but for a karma yogi, it is not a fear, it is love. Therefore, it is called yajna. Yaj means to worship. When do you worship? When you worship a person, or when do you adore the person? When you love the person, you adore the person. You worship the person. Therefore, a karma yogi only has real bhakti, and therefore you worship the Lord. You worship the Lord by following this panchavida maha yajnaha. And therefore, only Bhagavan Krishna says, this eshaha ishtakamadukh bhavati. Eshavos ishtakamadukh. Eshaha tu ishtakamadukh. Ishtakama. Ishtakama is ishtaha. Abhishtaha. Kamaha, the desires. Kamyate iti kamaha. That which are sought after, desired after. The kamaha, referring to these padartha, kama padartha, the objects of desire. This will be the giver, the provider of the objects of your desire. What? This karma yoga. This yeshaha, referring to this karma yoga, this yeshaha, yajnaha, maha yajnaha, this yajna, this karma yoga, which is the yajna, doing which, observing which, following which, that will give you with abhyudaya, nishreyasa, lakshanaha, kamaha, which will provide you with both material and spiritual prosperity. Dharma, artha, kama, it provides you. And also, through karma yoga, you will gain chitta shuddhi, jnana yogyata prapti, you will gain jnanam, and therefore moksha also. Therefore, it becomes dogdha. It becomes dogdha, duk bhavati, kama duk bhavati, kamam dogdi. It becomes a provider of all your kama. What kama? Dharma artha kama, moksha, purushartha, that purushartha, That is what is sought after by you, that it is the provider. Karma Yoga is the provider of that. Therefore, you have to follow Karma Yoga as a mumukshu. Karma Yogi is a mumukshu. The lifestyle of a mumukshu begins with Karma Yoga. A Karma Yogi, a mumukshu begins with Karma Yoga and ends up with jignyasa. First, it is mumuksha, moktim icha, the desire to be free by following what is to be done as ordained by the Shastra, as ordained by the Lord, not violating the order, doing what is to be done. Then that moksha icha turns into Brahma jignyasa. To gain that only we need to do this yoga called karma yoga, that becomes a sadhanam. So karma yoga, it promotes, it lifts a person from being a mumukshu to a jignyasu. For a jignyasu, jnana yoga. For a mumukshu, karma yoga. We can present like that also. For a mumukshu, karma yoga. A mumukshu is one who has a desire to be free. Because he has a desire doesn't mean he can give up karma and take to sannyasa. Not, he cannot do like that. Because for that, he should have certain pakvata, yogyata. Therefore, he has to observe karma. He has to follow his swadharma. That is why Bhagavan also advises Arjuna not to take to sannyasa, not to take to this jnana yoga. You do karma. Even though jayasi chet karmanaha, Arjuna has to, karmanaha buddhihi jayasi, kimartam aspin karmani, gore karmani mam niyo jayasi. Why do you propel me in this gore karma? Because you have to gain that pakvata, jnana yogyata. Therefore you do karma. It becomes your sadhanam by providing you whatever you ask for. Therefore, it is ishtakama dukkha bhavati. Therefore, karma yoga is called yajna. It is a worship. Work becomes a worship. If worship becomes a work, then it's a problem. It becomes a just mere karma. Any work can be converted to worship by bringing this attitude of karma yoga. And any worship also can be brought into karma by bringing in the attitude of near karma. That is what the worldly people do. They are called worldly people, materialist people. Karmis are materialist, whereas karma yogis are all spiritual sadhakas. So karma yogi is a spiritual sadhaka only. So therefore, Bhagavan addresses Arjuna. He addresses, in fact, all the spiritual sadhakas to take up to karma yoga to gain jnana yogyata. So in that discussion is on that is the panchamaha yajna that has to be followed. And here Bhagavan Krishna points out certain parts of portions of panchamaha yajna. First he talks about this Deva Yajna. We will read that next to Shloka. Shloka number 11, from which we have to start.
Devan Bhavayata Nena.
Devan Bhavayata
Nena. Deva Bhavayantu Vaha.
Deva Bhavayantu Vaha.
Parasparam bhavayantaha.
Parasparam bhavayantaha.
Shriyav paramavapsyata.
Shriyav paramavapsyata.
Not taha. Shriyam paramavapsyata only. Where is visarga?
Shriyaha paramavapsyata.
Okay.
Devan bhavayatanena te devaha bhavayantuvaha parasparam bhavayantaha. Parasparam bhavayantaha, the famous line. Parasparam bhavayantaha.
श्रेयः परम अवाप्स्यत. सो देवान् भावयतानेन अनेन भावयतानेन भावयता अनेन अनेन इज व्हाट दिस यज्ञेन व्हाट यज्ञ दिस कर्मयोगेन दिस पंच महायज्ञेन पंचविधेन पंच महायज्ञेन दट इज अनेन दट इज द मीन्स दट इज दि साधनम साधनेन कर्मयोग साधनेन देवान् भावय देवान् भावय देवान् इज देवान् हियर यू कैन टेक इट एज देवास लिटरली देवास और यू कैन ब्रिंग इन माता पिता एवरी ऑल द पीपल्स आल्सो यू कैन ब्रिंग इन ईश्वर ईश्वरः माता पितरौ एटसेट्रा सर्वान् दे आर देवा बिकॉज मातृ देवो भव पितृ देवो भव आचार्य देवो भव अतिथि देवो भव ऑल दीज आर देवा ओनली यू हैव टू वर्शिप देम एज द लॉर्ड माता पिता आचार्य एंड अतिथि द गेस्ट सो देयरफॉर भावय 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 मीन्स यू नरिश वर्धयत प्रसादयत भावय सो भावय भावय इज फ्रॉम द भू धातु पॉजिटिव यू हैव दिस एटीट्यूड भावय यू अप्रिशिएट यू रिकग्नाइज एंड एक्सप्रेस युअर सेंस ऑफ ग्रैटिट्यूड अप्रिसिएशन टू द देवा Deva is Indra, Agni, Vayu, Varuna, and we can bring in Mata, Pita, Atithi, Acharya, etc. So all the presiding deities of all the presiding deities of the laws of nature, and all the known deities who move around us in the form of father, mother, Acharya, and the Atithis. So towards them you express your gratitude. How? Anena yajnena, this yajna karma, by following this karma yoga, you express your gratitude, a sense of appreciation. So bhavaya, devan bhavaya. So anena devan bhavaya. Anena Devan Bhavaya. Through Anena, through Yajna, Yajnena, you nourish all the Devatas. You propitiate all the deities, the preserving deities of these natural laws, all aspects of nature. You propitiate. By doing what you gain, Te Devaha Bhavayantu Vaha. Devaha Bhavayantu. They nourish you. When you nourish them, how you nourish them? By expressing your sense of appreciation, the gratitude. The way of expressing your gratitude is not to violate the order. Not to disturb the harmony. For example, this water is there, river water is there. River water should not be polluted. That is the appreciation of Varuna Bhagavan. The river water, the Ganga water, it's a pure water. That should not be polluted. Ganga water, if you see in Calcutta or even in Rishikesh, you will see this gutter water also gets mixed up with Ganga water. It's a pure water. You are disturbing you are violating the nature, the order. So it makes the river water pure. People, they wash their clothes. Even they do all sorts of nonsense in the river water. Ganga is the goddess. For us, it is a holy river. So that sanctity, the purity has to be maintained. Similarly, the trees, the vrikshas, the trees have to be taken care. They should not be cut. The forest should not be destroyed. When you destroy the forest, you will not get rain. When rain is not there, food cannot be produced. Food is not there, food scarcity, and therefore hunger, people die. So when you have deforestation, then the nature provides you with whatever you ask for. This is called parasparam bhavayantaha. Therefore, devaha need not be the physically available devas. Deva in the form of the order, the forces which operate behind the nature. Devaha. So devaha, te devaha, vaha. Vaha is pishmakam, you. They nourish you. You nourish them, they nourish you. So you take care of them and they take care of you. You take care of them by not destroying. That is itself is big care. You don't destroy them. You don't destroy the sanctity. You don't destroy them. And in turn, they take care of you. So this is called parasparam bhavayantaha. So bhavayantaha. Yeah, that is by yajna, that by that you maintain the harmony, the harmony of the forces of the nature. So that is in that way you can harmoniously contribute for maintaining the order of life, the order of Ishvara. By being just a consumer, you consume everything, not being a contributor. Not only being a contributor, you destroy. That is against Ishvara. That is a violation against Ishvara. You are rubbing against the order of Ishvara. If you rub, you will get rubbed. Therefore, you be a contributor. You can be a consumer. You can be a consumer. Consume less, contribute more. Consume less, be less selfish, and be more unselfish, contribute more. So that is how the order, that is what the order expects from you. If you do, then they also nourish you. So in that way, parasparam bhavayantaha, parasparam bhavayantaha, nourishing each other. Nourish each other. Shreyaha param avapsita. You gain the shreyas, the ultimate, here it is ultimate well-being. You gain the ultimate well-being, paramaha shreyaha. The shreyas can be either in the form of the material prosperity or from this spiritual aspect, it can be moksha. So it can be dharma, artha, kama, moksha, everything. That is the shreyas. The word shreyas means here, your purushartha. What you want to gain, that you will gain. If you want dharma, artha, kama, then it provides you with that. Moksha, it provides you with that. Therefore, karma yoga, right? Karma yoga makes you a contributor, makes you contribute more and more, and not just mere consumer. So in the process of contribution, what happens? You grow. You grow into a big person. You expand yourself. You have expanded. You grow out of your limitation. It makes you grow. Karma yoga makes you grow by making you a contributor. Therefore, by following this yajna, here deva yajna, deva is an example as taken by Bhagavan and points out. Anena panchamaha yajnena devan bhavayata vardayata, you nourish them, vardayata. And they also, vaha yushman bhavayantu, they also vardayantu, let them also nourish you. So evam parasparam anyonyam, parasparam is anyonyam, mutually. What bhavayantaha vardayantaha. By that, what you get? You get shreyaha, you get kalyanam, mangalam, sukam, bhuyat, avapsyata, prapsyata. May you gain mangalam, sukam, avapsyata, prapsyata, labadvam iti. So propitiate the nature, and nature will propitiate you. Obey the order of the nature, the order of Ishvara. When you obey, when you follow, then they in return provide you with what you want. So this is called yajna. This is a yajna. So expressing your appreciation and gratitude to them properly, by doing that, you also will be protected and taken care by them. So therefore, parasparam bhavaya, parasparam bhavaya, by which you gain shreyas iti. Then here the word devan is there, therefore it is talks about dev yajna. This can be extended to all the other yajna. This bhuta yajna. So when you say deva, deva is the presiding lord of the forces, different forces of nature. So in the nature there are bhutas are there, manishyas are there. You take care of your fellow beings also. You take care of the pashu also, bhuta. So therefore, by that you get shreyas, shreyas avapsyata. The word shreyas, you can see it is used in sense of moksha. Here also the shreyas is used. So here, by karma yogena shreyas, shreyaha avapsyata, is you gain the immediate purusharta, what you ask for, immediate purusharta. Ultimately you gain moksha also. That is what the shreyaha is. That's why translated as mangalam kalyanam prapsyata, may you gain iti. Then the next shloka, ishtan bhogan hi vo devah,
ishtan bhogan hi vo devah,
dasyante yajna bhavitah,
dasyante yajna bhavitah,
tai dattana pradayaibhyah,
tai dattana pradayaibhyah,
yo bhunte stena eva saha,
yo bhunte stena eva saha.
So ishtan bohan devaha dasyante. So by following this karma yoga panchamaha yajna, ishtan bohan devaha dasyante. Dasyante is the future tense. Devaha, devaha is referring to the presiding deities of the forces of nature, the laws of nature. Devaha dasyante, dasyante, dasyanti. It is dasyanti, chandasam, dasyante. Dadatu, it is parasmepadi dhatu, dadati. Dasyante is the atmanipadi. It is permitted. For Vyasacharya, it is permitted. All this is all shishta. This is called shishta prayoga. The shishta purusha, they can use. So dasyante is equal to dasyanti. They will give. Who will give? Devaha. Deva, all the devas who have been propitiated by you, by your yajna, panchamaha yajna, by your yajna, karma yoga, they will dasyante, they will give you what? They will give you with whatever you ask for. Ishtan bhogan. Ishtan, abhishtan, the desired. Ishtan. Bhogan is this enjoyments, the objects of enjoyment. Dhanadhanyadi, dhanadhanya, putra, vaguputram. You say, no, in the ashirvada. Dhanam dhanyam bhagaputra labham virgamayuhu. So everything. So they provide you. Ishtan bhogan, all the objects of enjoyments they give you. Vaha, vaha is ishtan bhogan ki vo. What is vo? Vo is vaha. Vaha is ishmabhyam, to you. They give you all the desired objects. So when you receive, now you ask for and they give you. You ask for and they give you. And yajna bhavitaha. Yajna bhavitaha. One more word is yajna bhavitasyante. Yajna bhavitaha. That is referring to the deva. Yajnehi. There is panchamaha yajnehi. Bhavitaha. Yajna bhavitaha. Yajna bhavitaha means those who are propitiated by the panchamaha yajna. those were propitiated by the yajna. Who are those devaha? So yajna bhavitaha, referring to this devaha, the devas who are yajna bhavitaha, they are propitiated by you, they are pleased by your yajna. So te dasyante, te vaha yushmabhyam dasyante, they give it to you. Yajna bhavitaha is this yajna bhavitaha, yajnegi bhavitaha, yajna bhavitaha, referring to the deva, devas who have been propitiated by you, they dasyante, they give you with what you ask for, ishtan bhogan, that ishta bhoga, the enjoyments they give you. So you propitiated them, they give you. Now the second line, this you have received things from devata. Now you have to acknowledge, you have to acknowledge, like the WhatsApp itself, we expect acknowledge. What to talk about the acknowledgement when you receive something from the devata. So you acknowledge what the devatas have given and you offer them back also. You offer them back also. Acknowledgement of what we receive, and you express your gratitude in the form of offering them back. So whatever we receive, it is from Bhagavan only, and you have to give back, you have to offer back in the form of again continuing following this Panchamaha Yajna. And you just gain without acknowledgement and consume, then you are a thief. You are a thief. Dattan apradayebhyaha yaha bhunte saha stena eva saha apradayebhyaha taihi dattan, given by them, taihi referring to that devehi dattan ishtan bhogan padarthan, the deva who has given this, all the ishta bhoga, the enjoyments, apradayebhyaha, without acknowledging. Acknowledgement in the form of expressing your gratitude. Without acknowledgement, you enjoy. Then what is called that? Then you are called a thief. The one who enjoys all the bhogas given by devata without acknowledgement, without offering them back to them, is called a thief. It means you are just a consumer, not a contributor. So if you are not giving back to the Lord, that is giving back to the Lord, giving back to the society, giving back to the nature, then if you are just simply consumed, then you are a thief. Stenaha. Stena is thief. When you offer them back to the Lord, whatever you are consuming, and similarly you offer them, then that is called acknowledgement. That is called acknowledgement and contribution. When you contribute more and more, you gain more and more. By contributing more and more, you grow into a spiritual person. Therefore, karma yoga is that where you become a more and more contributor, less and less consumer. And that is the way you worship the Lord. The worship of the Lord is not a physical worship. By your action, you worship the Lord. By your action of offer, that contribution, offering to the society, offering back to the society. First you earn, then you give. First you learn, then earn and give back. You learn and you earn and not give back, then you become a thief. So the one who enjoys all the blessings given by the Bhagavan without the sincere expression of gratitude to the Lord, who made only all the enjoyments possible, then that person is called a thief. It's called Tenaha. So don't become a thief. Bhagavan Krishna says, Don't become a thief. You be a contributor. Magrada kasyas vidhanam. Even in Ishavasya Upanishad, it says, Magrada kasyas vidhanam. Never be a thief. For to be a thief, you need not literally steal the possessions of other people. By not being a contributor also, you become a thief. So, therefore, the one who consumes yaha bhunte, yaha purushaha, swayam eva, bhoga, bhoga padarthan bhunte, saha, apradayaibhyaha, taihi apradayaibhyaha, not offering them back to the devas. Devas is here, not offering back to the society, to the nature. Saha purushaha, stena eva, choraha eva, choraha eva. Then that what is the karma he is doing? He is doing chora karma only. It's not a karma yoga, it is an action. What action? Action of stealing. He steals. He steals the objects what he wants from the nature, violating and not offering them back. So two types. One is violation. Two types of papam he commits. One is he violates. When you don't offer, that is one papam. And also you violate and take away or usurp the nature. That is also the violation. That is also a papam only. So in both way you become a thief. Stena eva saha. Saha stena eva. Yaha bhunte. Saha stena eva. The one who enjoys is called a thief. Does it mean one should not enjoy? No. Yaha apradayaibhyaha. Apradaya taihi dattan. Given by them. Apradayaibhyaha. Apradayaibhyaha means not giving back. The apradaya. Dadatu. Na dattva. Adattva. Not giving back. When you consume, not giving back, then only you become a thief. Consuming is not a problem. Consumption, everybody has to consume. For survival, you have to consume. Without consumption, without consuming, one cannot live. So everybody is a consumer. But to be a mere consumer or wanting to be a contributor, for that, one has choice. If you are a mere consumer, nature also will consume you. If you become a contributor, the nature also will contribute for your growth. That is what the previous sloka, Bhagavan Krishna says, parasparam bhavayantaha, by which shreyaha param avapsyata, you gain param shreyas. Iti. Then, the next sloka, we will read. Yajnashishtashinas santaha. Mujyante sarva kilbhishaihi. Punjate te tvagham papaha. E pachantyatma karanad. So, yajna shishta shinaha santaha sarva kilbishahi uchyante. This is a statement, vakya. So, sarva uchyante. Uchyante is a kriyapada. Uchyante means they become free. Muchdatu, release. They get released. Uchyante. From what? Uchyante sarva kilbishahi sarva papaihi. Kilbisha. Kilbisha is papa. Sarva kilbishaihi sarva papaihi muchyante. Ke muchyante? Santaha, sadavaha, manushyaha. Who are those people? Yajna shishta shinaha. It's a beautiful word. Shishta is yajna shishta shishta shinaha. That is yajnasya shishtam. Yajna shishtam. Shishtam is shesham. What is left over? what is left over after yajna, that is called yajna shishta. Like when you have bhojanam, after bhojanam you leave certain things, you don't eat, you leave it, that's called shishta, leftover. What you left over is consumed by the other beings, animals. So what is you don't, what you don't consume, that other beings consume. What other beings don't consume, that some other beings consume. That is how the order is. So what is left out, left over after yajna? This bhojanam is also yajna. You are offering to the Vaishvanara Agni in your stomach. This is a yajna. That's why Brahmarpanam Brahmavihi is said. It's looked upon as an yajna. And you offer agudi into that. The agudi is annam, jalam, ityadi. So now, what is left over after yajna is called yajna shishta. Yajna shesha. So yajna shishtam ashitam shilam eshamte. Yajna shishta shinaha. That is the one who takes, one who partakes or consume what is left over after yajna is called yajna shishta shinaha. Yajna shishta shinaha means yajna shesha bhojinaha. Yajna shesha bhojinaha. That is taking, consuming, partaking what is left over after yajna. That is the one who does that. Those who consume, who partakes what is left over after yajna. That is called, they are called yajna shishta shinaha. It means after contributing to society or to the nature, to the order, whatever remains that you enjoy as prasada, that you enjoy as the prasada, that prasada buddhi. This is called Ishvararpana buddhi, prasada buddhi, karma yoga. So after giving back, you enjoy what is left over. That is, they are called yajna shishta shinaha. And they become free. They become free from all the vipapa. So when you lead a life of contribution, doing your duty, taking care of your family, taking care of the society, then you make use of whatever remains. You make use of whatever remains and that you consume as prasada. Then you become a yajna shishta. Then what you consume is an amrita. That it becomes an amrita. Because you will become free from papa. Sarva papehi kilbishehi papehi mucchante. When you become free from papa by consuming what is left over, then what is that you consume? You consumed amrita. You consumed amritam. By consuming amritam, you become free from papa. It means you be a contributor. That is, in short, that is what it means. You contribute more and more. When you contribute, you will also get back. You will also get back. It is not that you just will be, remain a contributor. The order will give you back. And that you accept as yajna shishta, that is called prasada. That prasada will become an amrita by which you become free from papa. It means you get antakarana shuddhi. You become a matured person for qualified person for the pursuit of this spiritual life. So therefore you become a yajna shishta. In our daily karma, we do five types of the karma which are generally harmful to the beings. We husk the paddy, asking the paddy, in those days, asking the paddy, taking the rice. When we do certain, the beings are killed. Then the grinding of the grains, the flour in the kitchen, you do the grinding, powdering. Then in the fireplace, when you burn the chulli, there also in the chulli, in the wood, some beings may be there, insects may be there, that are also are killed. Then in the water, you fetch water from the water body, that when you take water, you are depriving the animals from having water, or you are there may be some himsa involved in that. Then when you sweep and mop the floor, there also ants, insects are killed. These are the five types of violence which we commit in the place where we live, where we survive. These five papam we commit. These are the five places of himsa that a grihastha generally commits. Not only a grihastha, everybody commits. But grihastha is a generally. So therefore, only grihastha is expected to do this panchamahayajna to neutralize these five types of himsa. Since five types of himsas are involved in survival, in living, therefore, you have to neutralize that by doing five types of himsa, five types of yajna. To neutralize the five types of himsa, you have to do this panchamaha yajna. So therefore, if you don't do, then what will happen? Then this will be a papam. This will remain a papam, and that papam will become an obstacle in your spiritual pursuit. Therefore, by adopting to Karma Yoga, by leading the life of more and more contribution, you free from papa, and therefore it becomes conducive for your spiritual pursuit. This Panchamaha Yajna will become conducive, will make your life conducive for Chitta Shuddhi and therefore Moksha pursuit. Therefore, only Panchamaha Yajna is recommended, because you may ask, I'm not doing any papa, why should I do this yajna? We are doing papa. We are doing unknowingly or knowingly, we commit all this papam. We hurt people, we hurt beings living around, small from the small insects to the big animal, we do. Therefore, to neutralize that, we have to do panchamaha yajna. That's why bhuta yajna is also important. Deva Yajna talked about, Bhuta Yajna also. So, therefore, leading a life of contribution and accepting whatever comes as prasada, by which you become free from papa. The papa because of killing the insects, killing the living beings, that is a papam. That papa gets neutralized by this lifestyle of Karma Yoga. Now, Bunjate, second line, Bunjate te toham papaha e pachantyat atma karanat. Here Bhagavan Krishna says, how this offering is important. Offering of what you cook. Pachanti is taking an example for pachanakriya, that cooking action. Pachantya atma karanat pachanti. E pachanti atma karanat. Those who cook, ye is those who cook for themselves. Those who cook, you can take pachanti as literally as a cooking kriya, or pachanti you can take as an upalakshana for living. Those who live for themselves, that is those who are selfish. Those who are selfish, those who live for themselves, or those who cook for themselves, it means without offering to others, without offering to the Atithi, without offering to the other Bhutas, other animals. Those who cook only for themselves and they consume what? They are papaha. They are called papis. So if you cook only for yourself, then you are papi. Why you are papi? Because you are eating the papam. What you cook also becomes a papam. So you consume the papam, therefore you become a papi. Bunjate te toham papaha. Ye atma karanat pachanti te bunjate. They consume. What do they consume? Agam papaha. Agam papaha. They consume papa only. Bunjate. Ye atma karanat pachanti te bunjate. Agam. Agam is papam. They consume papam and therefore they become papi. Papaha. Papaha referring to the people. Papatmanaha. duskritinah, that manushyah, manushyah papah bhavanti. Those people will become papis because they eat papam. Why they eat papam? Because they cook for themselves. They consume what they cook without offering to others. Here pachana kriya, as I said, you can take it as an upalakshana and you can extend to other kriya, other karma. So those who consume without offering, those who are consumer, not being a contributor, what do they consume? They consume papa, therefore they are papis. Papaha, they are all papaha. Papaha referring to the people. Papaha, they become papis. Because they bunjate, kadanti. What do they eat? They eat, they consume, they consume what they have cooked. They only consume without offering to others. So pachanti, pakam nirvartayanti, atmanaha pachanti, atma karanat pachanti. Atma karanat is, here atma is not sachidananda atma. Atma is for oneself. It is reflexive pronoun. Atmanaha svasya hetoho. For oneself they cook. For oneself they live. For oneself they consume everything without offering it back. They become a papi. Why they become papi? They eat papa. Whereas when you contribute and take, consume what is left over, then you become a punyavan, because what you consume is amrita, by which you become sarvakilbishaihi uchyante. You become free from all the papa. That by which you become free from all the papa is karma yoga. So karma yoga, being a karma yoga, is being a contributor. That by which you become a papi is that consumption. When you are a mere consumer, then you become a papi. So that is the difference between the karma yoga and karma, mere karma. Karma yogis are, they are all punyavan. And karmis are all, they are all papis. Because they eat papam, therefore they are papi. Whereas karma yogis, they eat amritam. Eat means not literally eat, it means they consume, they enjoy. They enjoy amritam because they are yajna shishta shinaha. So two things are talked about, yajna shishta shinaha and atma karanat e pachanti. Ye yajna shishta shinaha. ये आत्मकारणात् पचन्ति ते अगम बुञ्जते ते अगम खादन्ति दे अगम इज पापम द वर्ड अगम इज पापम इन गीता भगवान कृष्ण अड्रेसेस अर्जुन ए अनघ मया अनघ इवन इन दिस चैप्टर इटसेल्फ दिस सा लोकेस्मिन् द्विधा निष्ठा पुरा प्रोक्ता मया अनघ 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 इज न अघ अनघ अघ इज पाप न अनघ इज apapa. So Arjuna, oh Arjuna, you the one without any fault, blemishless, without any papa, anagha. Here it is agam. Twagam is what? 2 plus agam, yansandhi. Agam. Agam is papam. Agam bunjate. Ye atmakaranat pachanti, te agam bunjate. They consume papa. Therefore they are papaha iti. So therefore, be a contributor and you can be a consumer, but consume less. Consume less, contribute more. That is what the Karma Yoga is. Then the next shloka, we will read. The beautiful cycle is talked about here. How this creation is sustained by this Pancha Maha Yajna. The creation itself follows this order. Order is Yajna. अन्नात् भवन्ति भूतानि पर्जन्यादन्न संभवः यज्ञात् भवति पर्जन्यः
यज्ञकर्म समुद्भवः So here Bhagavan Krishna brings in how this in this cycle there is a contribution. There's a contribution happening at every stages in this cycle. The cycle in the natural cycle. Even if we take vriksha, the vriksha gives fruits. Does it give fruits? Does it take fruits what it gives? Does it give fruits for itself? No. It gives fruits for others. That's the Subhashitam. Paropakaraya palanti vrikshaha. Paropakaraya vahanti gavaha. Paropakaraya vahanti nadyaha. Paropakarartam idam shariram. So this shariram is for what? Para upakara. If you are para upakara, then karma yogi. That is contributor. If you are para apakara, then you become a papi, papaha. Paropakarartam idam shriyam. Subhashita is a simple subhashita. With a little knowledge of Sanskritam, you can understand subhashitam. That talks about karma yoga. Paropakarartam idam shriyam. This body is for what? For the para upakara. For the, it is for the welfare of others. Is for meant for contribution. Yata vrikshaha palanti. The trees gives fruits for whom? Paropakara, for others. Similarly, gavaha, the cows give milk for others. Nadi flows, nadi, the river gives water for others. Similarly, this body is also, the shariram is also meant for offering service to others. Then that becomes a karma yoga. So without the nature, everything offers. Only the human beings alone are consumers. As I said, consumption is not a problem, but not offering back, holding it back, hoarding, that is a papam. The nature, everything follows the order of contribution. When you poke in and violate the order and be a when you become a consumer, when you consume, not giving, then the nature will give you back. So for that sake, at least one has to be a karma yogi. Even if not for the spiritual purpose, if not for the spiritual purpose, even for the even for the well-being of oneself, even for the mental, physical well-being of oneself, one has to be a karma yogi. There is no choice. Even if you are not a mumukshu, you have to become a contributor, because mere consumption will disturb your life. You cannot lead a peaceful life. Then when everything in the nature is follows this harmony of contribution, and you are the only person violating the harmony, then nature will know how to handle you. So therefore, Bhagavan Krishna from this shloka, he presents the beautiful cycle. Annad bhavanti bhutani. Annam is food. Bhutas, they survive because of annam. And how this annam is produced? The annam is produced by the rain. How the rain is produced? The rain is produced by the yajna. The yajna is the yagadi yajna, the homa which is conducted. That produces rain. There is a special yajna called kariri yajna by which the rain comes. The yajna. So yajna bhavati parjanyaha. So therefore yajna karma samudbhava. Therefore everything is produced of this yajna, this karma yoga. So therefore there's a cycle. In the cycle everything is a contributor. We'll see. We'll look into this shloka more in the next class. यम ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्र रुद्र मरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति हृव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यम सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यम योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरा सुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ
धन्यवाद गुरुजी
धन्यवाद गुरुजी
धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद गुरुजी
धन्यवाद शरण जी।